equals H plus 8 divided by 2. As we work through this, let's not forget there is an order of operations we all agree to use. Okay, so maybe let's start by cleaning up the left or right side or both if possible. Alex?
You could times 2. Well, what I did was I took 8 divided by 2 and got 4.
Great, I like that. Negative 3 equals H plus 4, right? Because order of operations, not the right order of operations. Which order of operations?
Distributive.
The one we
decided to use. That's all. It says that we're going to divide before we add. So when it comes to this 8, should I divide first or should I add first? The order of operations we use says we divide first. So we get a 4 there. Now what?
You're going to subtract 4 from each side.
Great. And we're done. H is negative 7. Sean?
41.
41. You're not going to make me do the whole homework assignment, are you?
No.
We'll see. It's a class. That is what we are going to wind up trying to do. Okay, so there's some ants. These can be tricky. There's some ants that can carry 50 times their body weight. It takes 32 ants to carry the cherry that's in that picture. It's 4,800 milligrams. It's a 4,800 milligram cherry, 32 ants. And rather than just trying to like force our way to figure it out, we're going to write an equation, okay? 32 ants carry the cherry. About how much does each ant weigh? Okay, so the assumption here is that all of the ants, all 32 of them, are carrying this one cherry all together, and that each one of them is putting so much work into it that they're carrying their full capacity of 50 times their own weight. Right? Okay. So what kind of an equation can we write that accounts for there's 32 ants carrying one cherry, they're each carrying 50 times their own weight, and there's this cherry that they're carrying that's 4,800 milligrams. Let's just think of it as 4,800. I have to do some thinking. If I give you the answer, then what is that, Josie?
Maybe it's like 50x equals 4,800 divided by 32.
Okay, so talk to us about that. What's that?
I don't think I did that right.
Well, tell us what you're thinking, and maybe if it's not
like
going to work.
Because like 50 times their own weight.
Yeah.
So that would, I don't know, I just kind of guessed. I threw some numbers in the order.
Okay, 50 times their weight. Okay, we'll assume each ant weighs the same, right? So we take all of the ants, and we multiply them by 50. Well, wait, what does X represent?
The weight
of what?
One ant.
Well, of one ant. So if you take the weight of one ant and you multiply that by 50.
That would be 50 ants.
That would be the weight of what?
50 ants.
The weight of 50 ants. Well, I suppose it would. Yeah, but that is, let's say that we took the weight of an ant and multiplied by 50. What do we know about that ant now? It can carry that much, right? Does that make sense? This is how much an ant can carry. One ant can carry this much. Okay, that's good. It's not random. It's not the random smashing together of two things, right? It makes sense. If we were to take X and divide it by 50, I don't know what that would mean. That would be a 50th of one ant. That wouldn't make much sense, but this does make sense. Okay, let's see if it is equal to this. Let's talk about this. 4,800, okay, the entire cherry. Divided by 32. Why 32? What's 32? Yes?
How many ants there are?
32. So we take all of the weight of the entire cherry and we divide it into 32. What's that?
150.
150. What does that represent if we take the 4,800 divided by 32 ants?
How much?
Please have all remaining users who have not yet voted come.
Think about it. You got this cherry, we're cutting into the 32 pieces, which is kind of hard to show, but I'm gonna just keep cutting it. Imagine I cut into 32 pieces, right? So this represents that little piece. Is that right? This number here represents that little piece. Who's responsible for that little piece? An ant, right? So this represents, to put it in words.
So that represents like when you do the 150, and she said, that's how much each ant is carrying.
That's how much each ant is gonna have to carry.
Yeah.
If they're all 32 of them together, they're gonna carry the whole thing. So, how much one ant has to carry? How much? What did this represent?
How much weight?
How much weight? What could carry? One ant. Right. This is the weight of one ant times 50. How much? That's the word much. How much one ant can carry? Should how much weight one ant can carry be equal to how much one ant has to carry? Yeah, we make the assumption that they're all maxed out on the amount that they're carrying right now, right? So,
yes.
What do you think of this equation then? It looks good. Right, we take the total weight of the cherry divided among every ant, and now we know how much weight each ant has to carry. We take the weight of a single ant multiplied by 50, we know how much weight that ant can carry. How much weight an ant can carry equals how much weight an ant is going to have to carry. Right? It's true. This equation must be true. Okay. Now it's kind of a mess, but that's all right. We'll just keep going. 50x equals, Charlie told us what?
150.
Figure out now how much an ant weighs.
Do 5 by 50 on both sides.
Mm-hmm. What's 150 divided by 50?
3.
So how much does each ant weigh? 3 milligrams. Okay. So you can try it that way. I mean, I don't think Josie was just purely randomly throwing stuff out there.
I just didn't remember why I did.
Good to put it down and then try and make sense of it, right? Maybe write down the units, milligrams divided by ants, milligrams per ant. Okay, x milligrams times 50.
Of itself. 50
times per ant. I mean, it's not really 50. Doesn't really have a unit, right? It's like per. This 50 represents how many more times each ant can carry, right? So you also get milligrams per ant here. Just try and reason through it. See if those two things are equal to each other. Okay. The way I thought of it was, I thought of this equation, 50 times x, because that's the weight that one ant can carry, right? I'll take that, I'll multiply that by 32. Because there's 32 ants, what should that come out to be? 4,800, right? One ant can carry this much times 32 ants, you know, are in the mix. Should come out to be 4,800. That's also true. Right? Which, look, if I multiply both sides of this equation by 32, I'll cancel the 32 there and I'll wind up with the 32 there. So they're the same equation, essentially. Not everybody's equation is going to look the same, so just reason through your equation and make sure it makes sense. Okay, that was 41. Next question. Josie?
I believe it was number 47.
Okay, all the way in here. So a little review. 47, 1/4 g plus 6g equals, minus 2/3. Minus 2/3. So we're just simplifying this expression. Charlie?
You're going to add 1/4 to 6 because they're like terms.
OK. Okay, G and G, they're both like terms of the same kind of thing, apples and apples, right? We're just putting them together. So Charlie, what does that give us? How many G's is that?
Oh. Wouldn't it be like 1/4 G plus 6/1? And then wouldn't you have to take common denominator?
Sure, do that.
So, on the right, you have to times 4.
4, 24/4. So 25/4 G minus 2/3.
Yep.
And it works. Sean?
I just did 6 1/4.
6 1/4 G minus 2/3. Is that the same?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is, yeah. This is 24/4 and another 4 is 25/4. Or if we would write this as a mixed number, we get 6 1/4. Okay, good. All right, let's go to 1.2. 1.2 questions. Sean?
I don't remember which. Can you go back to the answer page? Because I don't remember which problem it was.
This is where we write these down, right?
Yeah.
Write down the number that you had a question on.
I think it was number 8.
Number 8.
Yeah, it was number 8.
Okay. Okay, let's see, two things, like two options for what we can start with, Charlie.
You can add 1.1x plus 1.2x.
Okay, and get 2.3x minus 5.4 equals negative 10. Charlie?
You're gonna add 5.4 on each side.
All right, 2.3x equals, what would that be?
Is that 4.6?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
negative
4.6. And then? Cadence.
Divide by 3.2 on each side.
2.3. See how this, you can think, okay, move the decimal place over one for both of these, 23 and 46.
Negative 2.
Next question. Ready?
17.
It's like the averages question. 17. Yep. So there's this table that tells us on the first show, this concert. Is it a concert? It just says shows. Might be a play, might be a concert, who knows what it is. At the first show, 2,580 people show up. The second show, 2,920 people show up. On the third show, let's say the third show hasn't happened yet. You're like in charge of this theater, and you get a bonus if you average so many people per night. Okay, so you want to know how many people are you going to try and get in that theater so that this happens. That we get an average attendance of 3,000 over the three shows. How do we find averages? Add them up, right? Add the numbers up. Add up, say, three numbers, and then divide by
three.
So we add them up, we divide by three. Okay. So we're going to add these up. We're going to add up what? What numbers? 2580 plus 2920 plus x, right? We don't know what it should be. We know what the average should come out to be, right? When I add these up and do what else? Divide by 3, I should get 3,000. That's what we want the average to come out to be. Now we have an equation that's true, that x would. The x that we're looking for would fit perfectly. If we knew the right one, we added them all up and divided by 3, then we write up with 3,000. So how are we going to solve this equation? Cadence?
Well, I was just looking at it right now,
huh.
And I show until you get 3,000 and take how much over you added and like set it off to the side. Do the same thing to the second show, set it off to the side, and then add that to 3,000 and get your third show.
Hmm.
That's
what 3,000 and 3,000. Start at 3,000. I suppose you could. Because if we had 3,000 plus 3,000 plus 3,000 divided by 3, we'd have 3,000. And so this isn't like, we'll just start with this being 3,000 plus whatever extra we needed from these previous shows to get up to 9,000. Right? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that is a very good common sense way to think about it. But again, we're starting with simple equations to build good habits for solving algebraic equations so that later when they're more difficult and there's not really a straightforward, obvious thing to do. But what we'll see is pretty much what you said. To solve it algebraically, we want to do it by canceling things out on both sides and all that. You know, do the same thing on both sides. But let's use what Caden said. You know that you want this when it's divided by 3 to come out to be 3,000, right?
Okay.
So this plus this plus this last number should come out to be a number that when you divide it by 3, you get 3,000, right? What number would that be?
9,000.
Now let's see how I could have done that just using algebra. But if I multiply by 3 over 1, right? Now cross-canceling, I get 3 divided by 3 is 1. And now there's a 1 down here, and it's all that over 1, so it might as well just be the numerator there. And multiply by 3 on the right side as well, and what's 3,000 times 3?
9,000.
You did essentially what I did here, just a little bit of common sense. That's great. Let's turn it into our ability to see this divided by 3 and know that if we multiply by 3, we'll cancel out that 3. Okay? All right. But, I mean, that's exactly what's going on here. I was saying that this has to add up to 9,000, and then how are we going to solve for x? What's that? Divide by 3? You want to divide all this by 3? Just take a look. We have x here, plus 2920 plus 2580. How would you get x by itself? Like we just want x. We don't want 2920 on this side. We don't want 2580 on this side. Minus 2580. Minus 2580. So 2920 plus x equals
7.
Okay, then what? Sean?
Subtract 2920 and
both sides. Subtract 2920 plus x?
Yeah.
Well,
no, not the plus x.
Not the plus x? Why am I subtracting 2920 right here?
You get x by itself.
Why is x by itself? Not quite by itself, but it's there with a number that doesn't make any difference.
One.
Plus.
Yes, this is just a little. Take a look at what we get. 2920 minus 2920, 0 plus x on this side. So, yes, just x. Minus 2920 on this side.
3,500.
3,500. X is Yeah, if you assume, if you kind of started with this being 3,000 and saying, well, this isn't 3,000, it would need 80 more, this would need 220 more, no, 420 more, then it would add up to 500.
Plus 8, 8, 8, 8, 5.
Right. Yes?
I did it the way that Cadence was saying at the beginning.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't know how to do it that way, so I just used my best knowledge. And
it's better to do that than to do nothing.
Yeah.
I
got the right answer, but I didn't know the way Cadence
was
saying.
That's great. I mean, I appreciate the not giving up attitude. Let's figure this out. But let's also, while these kinds of things are a little more common sense, so we can see what the right answer would have to be, develop these skills, right? I know you're all working on it. Because if I throw this equation out at you without any context, you may not be able to reason it out that way. Or if we have just a more complicated equation, we're going to need the ability to cancel things out on both sides, keep both sides balanced. Okay? So great job figuring that out, and now you can see how what you thought of really matches up with what we did here. So it's good. There we go. There's some the algebra way to go about it as well. One more question? Or no more, but are there any other questions? If not, then we'll prepare for desks. No? Standard operating procedure here. Who can tell me what Dolores did correctly in the blue step? From here to there. Blake? Distributed negative 3. Correctly, right?
Yeah.
Distributed negative 3 correctly. But then what does Dolores do that's incorrect right there? Johnny.
He makes it himself. You would have to distribute the 4 and the...
Yeah, I've seen this a few times, and it's worth mentioning that the 4 just slides on over for no reason whatsoever, and then gets multiplied by the 4, by the parentheses as well. It was never meant to be multiplied, right? 4 minus, or 4 plus, if you squeeze a plus in there, I think it'll become more clear. You're not supposed to multiply 4 by that parenthesis. You're supposed to add it to whatever you get from the parentheses, right? So how would you fix it, Sean?
You would get rid of the parentheses and just plus
and
minus.
Add that stuff on, okay? Don't distribute that number in as well. Okay, let's jump back here real quick before we take off. Hey, what are the zippers about? Chill with the zippers. All right, step number 1, what would you do? Sean?
Combine like terms.
What?
Combine like terms.
Combine like terms. 5x minus 3x, 2x plus 2 equals 18. And then?
Yes. Minus 2 on both sides.
Subtract 2 on both sides, which is 16, and then? Charlie,
divide 2
and
7.
And we have 8. Okay, so you run miles for some reason. I don't know why, but you ran it in 5.5, 5.7, 5.3 minutes the last 3 times you ran. You're going to go for a run for a 4th time. We're going to figure out how fast you have to run that mile to average 5.4 cadence.
5.5 plus 1.7 plus 5.3 plus x.
Plus the unknown time.
Equals... 5.4 times.
Okay. That's true, right? It would be just as true as if we had said divided by 4 equals 5.4, but Cadence just multiplied both sides by 4 before he, you know, that was like his first thing to do, like in your head, you just multiply by 4 on both sides. We'll subtract 5.5, subtract 5.7, subtract 5.3, and we'll know what x is, right? And I know we're running short on time, so that's it. Any other questions? No?